and square foot analytics. And you know what I mean? Like, those are all things that are really important to retail. What is the value of the person who comes through that door? What's your foot traffic like? And I think that when we go over to either an online business or a social media style business, we have to know what the value of that transaction is. And I would rather, I've always said that in all of the classes that I teach on social media, that I would rather have 3,000 dedicated followers than a fan base of 70,000 nameless, faceless people.
Yeah.
And they don't mobilize at all like you would when you have this like really core group. Yeah. And even in amongst your big number of people, right, people who have 60, 70,000 followers, they still have a core group of people who are their super fans.
Yeah.
Even I have super fans.
Yeah.
And I know exactly who they are. Yeah. And I know exactly what they buy. And I know exactly what, you know, I could put out in front of them that they would really love to purchase from me.
Yeah.
And I think that it's more of creating that environment than trying to amass that, you know, again, that the other side of it, which is this, you can have 75,000 followers, but what good is it if they don't buy anything?
Yeah. I mean, that's what's so interesting, right? That, like, their power, it's about, like, I'm always about cultural, you know, cultural capitalism, like your cultural power, like your buying power, and just who you are. Like, if you get if you have 70,000 followers, you actually have followers, you know, like, are they following you?
Right.
I don't know. It's really interesting. So that was interesting. I also find that our group is, I really like the group. I don't want it to get bigger because the people on there are really nice and they're really engaged and fun. And, you know, it's amazing to sort of see, like, they're becoming friends and they know it. You know, you start to recognize the patterns of people and we're interviewing them. Mm-hmm. And so that's been interesting too, that you know, it's not about being a big group, and maybe, I don't know, that's been weird. So I don't know, like, we want to grow the podcast just because that's what you're supposed to do, but I don't know about the group. So
the group is sort of groups are, again, and we have to remember from a Facebook aspect, right, they announced at the beginning of the year that community was what they were focused on, and more close personal interactions, right? Mm-hmm. And the way that pages are getting traction is to create highly shareable content that's going to get picked up by your friends, right? And then that's how your page is going to get that better reach without paying for it.
Yeah.
And then, but what people are starting to realize is, oh, Facebook's put a lot of work and a lot more emphasis on groups. And every group that you join now, its default is set to let you know about every single post that happens in that group.
Like, your individual friends are just disappearing, right? It's hard. I rarely get stuff from my friends now. It's really weird.
Exactly, right? And so the group almost takes over, right? Because that group is having, like, really intense conversations and lots of interaction. And I'll tell you what, sometimes I open up my notifications, I have like 200, 300 notifications because all the groups, you know, have this person posted, this person commented, and this person, you know, is like, you know, it's almost a little bit too much. But on the other hand, what Facebook has said is, we're focusing on you and your interests, right? So if you're joining all these groups because you're interested in quilting, then they're going to show you that content, and they're going to show you that content a lot. And so for a brand like Just Wanna Quilt, you know, developing that group is going to be amazing. Yeah. The thing is that it's going to, by extension, grow. Yeah. And so, because Facebook's putting a higher priority on it. So
it's kind of remarkable.
You know, you might want to close it or restrict membership if that's what you're going to want to do, but
I know.
Obviously, I don't know if you would want to do that.
I don't know. We'll see. You know, I kind of like we take polls in the, all the time, so it's kind of interesting to sort of
see that. Yeah, yeah,
yeah. And so, and we, you know, we're like, you know, we're not usually we follow the poll. Sometimes it's like, well, that's great, but you know, we can't. Like they hated Pinterest. Nobody wanted to do Pinterest, which I thought was really interesting.
Mm-hmm.
They were like very anti-Pinterest. So okay, well, there's no reason to do more.
Well, from your copyright perspective, isn't that interesting,
yeah,
right? Because that's right. Usually where, like, a lot of copyright issues happen,
usually,
you know?
Right?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So, yeah. I saw it on Pinterest, they say, right?
Right? They do. That's right. So, yeah, so I don't know. I mean, I think it's been really interesting. The other thing we did is a ton of work on influencers this week. And the FTC disclosure requirements and the giveaway requirements. Mm. So we are going to put together a small – the team that did that is trying to finish it up. And then I think we're going to release it in every way we possibly can, including like on Amazon and things like that. So that's like our first thing that comes out of it, of sort of what you need to do to be legal and how to do that and what the issues are. And because, and then, you know, how to – but what was amazing to me was also that the people who were sending that were saying yes, we'll be that didn't really have any legal requirements. You know what I mean? Like they didn't say like, and you make sure that your FTC disclosure is in place or, you know, whatever. Like they didn't, like they just,
you
like,
know, to be honest with you, I don't think that most marketers think about that.
It's so interesting, right? Because they're coming down so heavily
on people.
They should
be thinking about it. Yes.
You know?
Yes. And disclosures, especially on when your brand is aligning with another brand,
right,
you know,
right.
And Facebook is even putting in a lot more rules as far as, you know, when your post is, you know, basically a sponsored post.
That's right. That's right.
You know, so, you know, for Just Want Quilt, again, being a lifestyle brand, this would mainly more affect you than me. Although it does affect, you know, product brands as well, right? But if I, let's say I, a product brand, want to align with you, a lifestyle brand,
right,
and you say, you know, Cheryl's heirloom sewing template is the greatest thing ever and we really love it.
Right.
That post on Facebook has to say that it is sponsored, co-sponsored
That's
with
right.
me.
That's exactly and, it. That's right.
And there is so much of that that's happening that nobody is paying attention to. And,
right.
And the rules on those are very strict.
Right.
Very strict.
We found that, like, even though, like, we don't get any money from anybody, right? Like, we're not getting a percentage or anything like that. But people are, I mean, companies are sending us samples, research samples, so that we can understand, I mean, for research. But because we talk about them, that we fall under being an influencer because, you know, we're we're getting free stuff and that we need to make sure that that's, you know, we mention that and there's all these different rules about mentioning it so that people recognize that,
right,
we did get free stuff and
Right. Yeah. Or you then have to say that this is not a sponsored post.
That's right.
And that,
exactly,
you know, we were sent this and we're reviewing it for review purposes only.
Right.
And then people are like, why do you have to say that? That seems like such an odd thing to have to tell people. But it's the law. Like, you have
to say
it, you know?
Right? So I think it's really important.
Oh, no. I mean, it's, yeah,
right?
I totally agree.
Yeah.
Totally agree. Because from a reviewer standpoint, absolutely. You know, like, you want to be able to say, like, we received a review copy of this, you know, whatever. And when you see that, then you say, well, okay, the opinion you're giving is your own,
right,
one, that it isn't sponsored. You weren't compensated for the,
yeah,
for the, you know, for the review. And that's an important thing too, from people who want to hear what their people's honest opinions about stuff.
Yeah.
So that's the clarity that aligning with brands and being sponsored and things like that. And I think that even kind of sort of comes in with some of the ambassadorship things that happen out there in the quilting world.
Yeah.
Like, we have to be really careful about that. Like, people always ask me whenever I'm teaching and I'll be in a lecture hall, right? And the lecture, I'll be giving a quilt lecture and inevitably there's always somebody who raises, I said, do anyone have any questions about, you know, all the quilts and everything that I've just shown? And people always raise their hand. What kind of batting do you use?
Right.
And it's like,
they want to know,
you know,
right?
That's, yeah. Well, they want to know. And then you feel like, okay, well, I want to tell right. you what I use.
Right.
But then, you know, if I started getting all of my batting for free.
Right.
And then I'm like,
right.
Right. And so how many people are, you know, a thread company ambassador who's not disclosing that
that's
they
right.
are,
yeah.
or, you know, a sewing machine ambassador that, you know, saying, well, I sewed my award-winning quilt on this machine. And
yeah.
now they think, well, if I buy that machine, I could be an award-winning quilter
that's
too.
Right.
And
that's right.
There's
that's
so
right.
many sticky
huge,
wickets
huge
for
things.
Being compensated for.
Yeah.
And the fact that you got even one thing free
right.
means you're compensated.
That's right. And, you know, I mean, and the compensation is like we are building. That's what was freaking me out about the giveaway because, you know, I do trade. My field is intellectual property and trademark and branding and all this stuff. So, like, suddenly our brand was connected to their brand. So I felt really, like, responsible. Like, suddenly, you know what I mean? Like, there was
oh,
this
yeah.
sort of, like, and
oh,
there wasn't
yeah.
any kind of, like, they were very nice about it. And we have three episodes with, so there's a generation. What I found cool about Stencil Company was three generations, the dad, the grandfather, the daughter, and the granddaughter. So we had already interviewed them. And so we thought, well, why don't we just try a giveaway with them? Because people will be listening all week to them. But
yeah.
it was, you start to see the numbers and you can start to see, well, you know, we're teeny tiny, like, you know, we're getting maybe 300 people a day listening to or downloading our episode. We're not huge, right? But you could see the power
still.
Of suddenly, you know, giving them 3 hours of marketing, of telling their story is worth something. Right?
Oh, yeah.
And so
oh, yeah.
that was really interesting, too, of like, you know, we're supposed to be an experiment, but then there's suddenly this kind of like, well, who are we going to have on and all those sorts of things. So I don't know. The whole thing is really fascinating.
No, and, you know, people ask me, they're like, well, what did you think you got out of the podcast? And I was like, well, why wouldn't I do a podcast?
Right.
You know?
Right.
But on the other hand, you know, I always felt it was really important in my whole career
yeah.
is to help, you know, other people so that we're not out here reinventing the wheel. Like, you know, there's information that can be shared. And I totally 100% think that, you know, if there's something in my power to do it, you know, to help people, I will
yeah.
do it. But, you know, I think that... You know, that we're all thinking that, you know, everyone's got their trade secrets and no
right.
one's going to share anything and I'm just sharing myself.
Yes.
And that's
is,
not the case, you know,
no.
for the most part.
Well, and the irony is like, well, you know, because I interview people all the time and like what they think they need to protect is usually not what they actually need to protect. So I mean, for the less sophisticated. You
oh,
know? So,
God.
So
yeah.
I don't know. It's been a great journey and everybody's been super nice and it's been really fascinating. I feel like I'm learning so much and people like you who are willing to talk with me and really try to understand what's happening here is so fascinating because again, I teach so my students are so excited about all this. So, you know, I'm teaching this IP and entrepreneurship class and so they've been doing all this stuff all and I'm like, well, you know, do you feel cheated because we don't like do the law every day? We try to figure out how to do it. And they were like, no. Like we all learn the law, but we never actually do it. So to be able to say like, oh, wow,
right.
you know, now suddenly we have to figure out how to do like the disclosure, like how do you do an FTC disclosure? We know the law, but how do we do it? It's been
right.
really, really amazing.
Yeah.
You know,
it's the law in practice.
Yeah.
It's the law in practice.
Yeah.
And, you know, again, there's so many in the quilt industry. And even so I'm part of a couple of online groups and like when it comes to copyright, there's just so much information, like
yeah.
misinformation.
There is.
And
there is.
And it's, you know, first of all, like I would go to a lawyer in a heartbeat and
right.
get it clarified for me. But
totally.
Most people's inclination is to like ask their friends, what
right.
do you think? Do you think I'm being infringed on? And the next thing you know, that's like turned into, you know, again, that's it. Remember we were talking about, and we talked about this in my class,
yeah.
you know, to use your powers for good.
Right.
Because
exactly. use your powers
when you
for
have
good.
This,
Right.
Yeah, you have this social media army at your fingertips.
Right.
And you're interested in whether or not they would go do things on command.
Right.
Oh, they can go do things on your command, to good or ill.